first form change we want to talk to you about is the residential lease agreement. The Minnesota legislature made some changes to the landlord-tenant statutes, and unfortunately, they did become effective immediately. So as of May 31st of this year, those legislative changes became effective. The Forms Committee did review those legislative changes and made some changes to our residential lease agreement, so you'll need to be aware of those changes that were reflected in that new form and begin using them effective May 31st for agreements entered into on and after that date. Specifically, the legislature made some changes for written residential leases. If you have a building with 12 units or more, the legislature is going to require that you specify that unit number that will be occupied to the tenant prior to them entering into the lease. So you'll notice in the lease, there is a place to place that unit number. For all written leases, you will now be required to have an affirmative start date and an affirmative end date in that lease. Additionally, if you will be allowing the tenant to prorate the rent, you will need to specify that on the first page of the lease.